Hello everybody, my name is DirectRex and welcome to episode 5 of Let's Build a Zoo in Minecraft. In the last episode, we built this lion enclosure as you can see. And I also added some mud, I guess you can call it, using soul sand and coarse dirt, which I think looks really, really nice. In this episode, we're going to be working on building the anteater enclosure. But before that, I would like to say thank you for helping me reach 50 subscribers. Yesterday, I saw that we reached 50 subscribers, which I'm so happy about. And it's so insanely nice. So I'm really, really happy that we reached 50 subscribers. It was my goal to reach 50 subscribers at the end of this year. And we finally did it. So thanks a lot for your support. And I hope you guys keep on supporting this channel. So as I said, today we're going to be doing the anteater. Now, if you guys had watched all the way to the end in the last episode, I had said we're going to be building the peacock enclosure today, but I got a comment, which I'm going to be putting up on the screen right now, which said I should do anteaters next. And I was like, you know what? Let's do it. So we're going to be doing the anteaters today. And there's a stupid crow which has been screaming for the past few minutes outside my house. So if you hear that, I'm sorry. So I have a creeper spawn egg in my hand because I want to use this to make the pond, and I think this is the exact center. Now all the enclosures that I saw on Google for anteaters, they were really, really small. They had like a small pond in the middle and they didn't have a lot of vegetation. So I really don't know if I want to do that. Like, I want to keep the animals in good condition, so I want to make it, you know, very nice and very cozy for them so they can live here happily. So I'm gonna blow up this creeper like so. There we go. And I think this should be enough. This is like a good sized hole over here for us to make a pond with. Now I'm gonna use what I did. I'm going to use a technique, what I did over here, like adding mud and all that. I think this looks really, really nice. And adding soul sand down below gives this bubble effect that I think looks really, really nice that we could use. So we need dirt actually. So I'm going to get sand. So let's get sand and let's fill the bottom with sand over here. No, I don't know why I did that over there. It's fine. So let me just, you know what, just screw it. I'm going to fill the entire thing with sand. So, yeah. I want to, like, have trees as well. Now, the enclosures which I saw, as I said, didn't have too much vegetation and all that. So, I don't know if anteaters prefer trees. Because I'm not some kind of expert on animals or something like that. So, you know, if I'm doing something wrong, feel free to comment it in the comment section below and tell me that I'm doing something wrong so I can change it in the next episode. But yeah, I think this kind of works. I wanted to have it like a muddy feeling, I guess you can call it. Let's get the water bucket out and let's fill the water in. There we go. I think this much amount of water should be enough for the anteaters to drink. And oops, we had a small lag spike over there. Yeah, I think that's a good amount of water. Let's make the outside part as well more muddy, I guess you can call it. Boom, there we go. We also need grass. Boom. I like this grass so much. Like, just the grass, like, as you can see. I don't know if there's a texture pack which only has this texture for grass, but I really, really would like to use it in just normal Minecraft and not only here. I think that looks really, really nice. And yeah, okay, fantastic. I didn't mean to break that. There we go. Let's start. Let's just finish this. This is taking so much time than I thought it would. Boom, there we go. Now we'll add here. Can I please fly up? There we go. Nice. And oh, I forgot to put heat here. All right. That kind of doesn't look nice. What if we add a little bit more? Not too much. How does that look? Yes, that's a lot more better. And I also saw that they were like logs, small branches which went over the pond. So I'm gonna try doing that. So I'm gonna get out the oak logs and get oak wood. So how do I want to do this? I don't know if it's gonna look nice or not, but let's try it out. Oh my god, what's happening? Okay. This is a stupid glitch which automatically just keeps on pressing the button and just starts moving automatically, which sucks. And it's so annoying. How do I want to do this? This is not coming out the way I thought it would. Let's not make it across. Let's try to make it near the pond, but wait. My imagination isn't working right now. Okay, what if we bring this like in a curve way and all the way here? I think that could turn out well. So let's try doing that. So let's do this. Oh yeah, we can also get out the... Oh, okay, I just threw the dirt over there. Okay, that's fantastic. Let's get out fence, because fence looks a little bit like thin branches. I guess you can imagine that. So let's bring out some like so, and probably do this. I'm so confused. This is so confusing. Okay, give me a second. Okay, I'm gonna do this. Then let's bring it out here, like so. All right. And then we can add a log over there and bring it like so. Yeah. Oh, yes. This is kind of what I was going for. Yes. Break that a little bit and add a log over there. Or over like so. Does that look better? Yeah, that does. All right, nice. Should we close the... Okay, I think we're gonna keep the opening like this. But we'll close it up at the tops so it doesn't look weird. So how does this look? Does this match up? Yes, it does. Oh, I didn't mean to break it. So let's place this on top. There we go. Nice. And we'll also use the oak fence a little bit, I guess. Maybe do something like that. And maybe something like that. Like that. Like that. No, that's too much, I guess. How does that... Yeah, that kind of looks good. Like, it looks like the branches which, like, they're poking out, I guess. You can see. Maybe one over here. How's that? Yeah. Okay, I like that. It looks like a fallen log or a branch which the anteaters can walk over and, you know, play around. Okay, that's nice. Now I also want to add some trees, so let's add a tree over here. I don't want too many trees, I want like two or three, I guess. So there's a lot of lag going on for some reason, I don't know why that's happening. So let's get out our bone meal, and I want this to be a big tree. So this is a technique that I use usually to grow the trees. So I, you know, put four blocks around, I break the down block, and I start bone milling it so it grows to be a big tree. Usually this works. Yeah, it had to happen, you know, just to make fun of me. All right, I see what you're doing, Minecraft. It's fine. Oh, this is a big tree. What am I talking about? This is a big tree. I think the down section is kind of broken, so we can fix that by adding leaves. Let's get some leaves. So where are the leaves? Here are the leaves. I'm bouncing around over here. So let's place that. My god, what is happening? Is my render distance too big? Too big. Okay, it's fine. Can I go to the... Yes, let me go to the video. It's just six chunks. It's the lowest it can be. Why is it lagging so much? Let me just add some here, I guess. Break that. How does that look? Does that look natural? Yeah, does that look natural? Yeah, I guess. Let's keep that. I also want to add one more tree, a proper big tree. Please be a proper big tree. So I think we can add one over here probably. And let me use another technique which I saw recently. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's try this. Yeah? No? Fantastic. That's exactly what I wanted. That's such a huge tree. Man, this is so annoying. Why can't I get a big tree? Just give me a big tree. It doesn't hurt. Yes, this is a big tree. Finally. Yes. Thank you so much, Minecraft. We should make it a little bit more natural, I guess. This kind of looks ugly over here. But yes, finally, we have a big tree in the enclosure. Very nice. Now, the only thing that is left to do is to add some grass here and there. Probably near the trees. Or do anteaters need grass? I don't know. But I'm gonna place some anteaters. So we have one here. Yes, look at him. He's already happy. Look at him trying to break the glass and go out. Okay, I'm sorry. And let's get another one. Yes, we'll be having two anteaters in the enclosure. And can we see them properly from outside? Yes, we can. And their nose kind of does pop out. We could also make like a ant hill, I guess. But that would be kind of unrealistic, right? Like, why would someone in their right mind put an ant hill in here? But I do need a way of feeding them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a back door, like I did for this enclosure here, where the staff members can come in and feed other ant eaters. So let's get some stone bricks. Let's get the buttons as well. There we go. Let's get the iron doors. Boom. And we need birch. I think we need birch fence, if I'm not wrong. So birch fence is like the official fence of this zoo. I also added some birch fence over here as well, telling there's gonna be what animal over here. Obviously it says peacock, which let's break it and let's fix it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's gonna be ant eaters, if I can spell eaters. So, no, that's wrong. Boom, there we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice. So ant eaters are gonna be towards there. And I also added another fence over here. I did this all off camera. We have lions over there. Oh yeah, I was supposed to put it with all caps. Break that once again. Boom, A-N-T, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there we go. And eaters, there we go, nice. Boom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, nice. So, I'm pretty sure I put birch fence here as well. Yes, I did, all right. But yeah, while I'm doing this, if you guys have any suggestions on what animal I should be adding next to the zoo, feel free to leave it in the comment section below. I would really, really appreciate your suggestions. Now, let's build this over here. Break that. Break. No, do not break that. Fantastic. Where's the glass? There we go. And let's place it back over here. All right. Yes. I'm making it double doors. So, you know, it's a lot more easier for the people to go in. Just in case there's an emergency. Can I please go in? Thank you very much. There we go. Very nice. Okay, let me just pop back in over here. Very nice. And we also have to add this sign. Staff only, do not enter. So what did I use? Oh, I used this. So that's 5. Did I use 5? I think I did. So staff only. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How does that look? Yes, that looks very nice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do. No. Oh, okay. There we go. do not enter. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice. Whew, finally, we have completed the ant eater enclosure. Yes, there we go. Very nice. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. I forgot to add the vegetation again. That's fantastic. Let me go over here. Very nice. Boom. There we go. I don't want too much grass around like the lions. Because it'll be kind of hard to see the anteaters. Because they are very small, as you can see. They're not particularly big. Yes, he went over the log. He went over the log. I knew these guys would enjoy this enclosure. Yes. I'm so proud of this enclosure, dude. Like this is just making my building skills a lot more better. That's nice. Do we need to add more logs? I guess no. I don't think we need more logs. Like it's gonna get too much. Tight spaced, I guess you can call it, and the anteaters won't have enough place to move around and have fun. So I'm gonna leave it like this, and yeah, that's gonna do it for this episode of Let's Build a Zoo. How does this look? Does this look nice? Should I change something? Should I add something? Leave your suggestions down in the comment section below. All suggestions is very appreciated. But yeah, I'll meet you guys next time. And until next time, keep working hard, never give up, and goodbye.